Let the healing begin. Let the healing begin.
Good evening, we're here in front of the CNN building in downtown Los Angeles. I'm with Cody, I'm with Martin from the front lines, and our brother Martin here. We're here to extend a solidarity with Standing Rock. Water is life, we can't drink oil. We want life, we want good things for our people. We want strength and solidarity with all the people here and indigenous peoples around the world. Cody?
Yes, I thank you guys so much for your love and support for us as we fight this this conglomerate of a black snake that is poisoning our lands. And it's a native issue due to the fact that it's on our homelands. It's right in our backyard. But it's a humanity issue. We are asking people from around the world to take a stand with us as we fight against this Goliath of a corporate company, of the energy company and the oil companies, which has never been done before. Too many people have been too scared.
Oil is for fire!
We are ready and willing to take this fight on, so we ask of your support. Stand with us.
Stand in solidarity with the people of Standing Rock. We want clean water. We want our basic human rights.
Is there any
treaties? Remember the ancestors.
Oh, thank you.
Is there anything you'd like to say to the protectors of Mauna Kea?
You know, we've been seeing you guys on the social feeds. We have been sharing. I've been sharing your stands. And you know, when we go to ceremonies and sweat lodge and house ceremonies, I keep you guys in our prayers for what you are doing. Keep up the fight. Know that even in the lands of the Lakota, you guys have our utmost support.
Mauna Kea. All right, we stand with you guys, Mauna Kea.
Protect Mauna Kea.
There you go. Thank you.
Aloha, my name is Alma. Standing Rock, and no to the Dakota Access Pipeline, and protect our sacred waters across the globe. Yes, water is life, ola I kamai, and we stand for our relatives on Boku Honu, on Turtle Island, and we're here to show our support.
Kukia I mauna.
Kukia I mauna.
Aha aloha aina. Mahalo.
Mahalo.
Oh, yeah. We're in front of the CNN building. Reporters of the protests against the Dakota Access Pipeline are here. Standing for Standing Rock. Protesting the fact that CNN again, once again.
Standing Rock.
Refusing the coverage of indigenous issues.
The indigenous here in Southern California, Los Angeles, they call it the City of Angels. Locally, we have a lot of challenges in our coastal zone, 2 miles from where the ocean is. We have a coastal act that's being challenged, so these struggles for territory, for land, and the preservation of sacred sites is here. And it's everywhere, and so we're here in solidarity today, Mauna Kea. We're in solidarity here today with Standing Rock, and we want to make sure that you know that we pray every day for you and your safety and for the water. And water is sacred, water is life, and it's a good day. Thank you.
I am the co-host and co-producer of American Indian Airwaves on KPFK, which broadcasts every Thursday from 7 to 8. So As with tradition, we want to recognize the people of the land, the Tongva people. As indigenous peoples, we always start with the people of the land. And so for our action today, our gathering today, in objecting to what in more honest times used to be called censorship and propaganda of the corporate censored news network, we want to ask one of our Tongva elders to start us off in a good way. And so with that, I want to acknowledge and welcome and Gloria Arianas, our local elder.
Thank you. Thank you for being here today. Thank you. You're blessing the land by your presence and respecting the people of the land. I am Tongva. I have been here all my life in this area, in the San Diego Valley, and we have been issues of our own here in the San Diego Valley with the Tongva people. So I'm going to do a small prayer, and I thank you for being here. Tongva. Thank you for being here. My name is Gloria Arianas. My traditional name is Sagasunabu, which means spirit blanket. I am an elder for our tribe, and I also am a member of the Tiet Society, as is Larry. And thank you, Limo, for bringing all your equipment out here today. And the prayer I want to say is thank you, Creator, for bringing us together today for this very important session. Thank you for bringing all these people from the nations to be here with us. And I'm very blessed to see you and to talk to you and be happy that you're here. Creator, thank you for blessings for our children, our elders, and our families. Please, everybody that is here, please honor their prayer requests for their health, for their well-being, for their safety. Creator, we ask for food for all those who are hungry, who are homeless. Creator, we ask for the safety of the water and the protection of the water. We are protectors. We are here to tell the world we want the mainstream to pay attention to us and know that we are here for a reason, for a very important reason. We send prayers to the people at North Dakota who are there. I've heard as many as 4,000 and sometimes more. And that is a Creator, thank you for the amazing act to bring us together as tribal people, because sometimes we fight with each other. So Creator, we're really thankful for this. I ask for blessings from the spirits of the land and the ancestors of the land. They hear your prayers. They hear what you are saying. Please, they will also assimilate that love and love to the people in Dakota. We know there's quite a few California people out there, and we ask for blessings on their journeys. Everybody who's here, safe journeys. For all of you that come here today, safe journeys. I hope. Okay, I've been asked for a song. If you know the ancestor song, it's a pretty much song that, you know, is a California song, and almost everybody knows it. So, if you know it, please sing with me. I'm going to push this away a little bit from my mouth, so I miss a lot of I only sing my songs in three verses because we were told once that we only have three directions. When we look to the west and the broad ocean, we see water. And we can see to the south, we can see to the east, and we can see to the east. So that's why I sing in three verses. Thank you.
I'd like to introduce our next speaker. He's a longtime community activist. He's a great human being. He's always there for the people, and he's here today again for the people. And I want to welcome from the Akmarawatham Nation, Shannon Rivers.
Thank you, everybody. I'm going to be brief. We have some folks that we want them to share. We want to also have a song from my daughter Kahara. But we're standing here in this corporate media block. And as you watch CNN, you see them talking for 12 hours straight about two people, Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton. You don't hear about Jill Stein. You don't hear about Oak Flat. You don't hear about Mauna Kea. You don't hear about the Dakota Access Pipeline and our relatives who are standing strong. You don't hear about that. So we have to gather in this crowded space where there's too many people and this water that is always, always dirty. These relatives, they don't know how to live on this earth. They don't know what it's like to be from the land. So they take and they consume. They're cannibalists. They're cannibals. And they eat and they destroy. And they continue to do so. And all of us here, we, this small group of people, we are in the front lines. We are the ones who are going to keep the people safe and strong. Even them that are up there in this tower. There's no large cameras here, there's no CNN. They won't even show this. Offer her some food. That's what we do. That's how we do it. And so I'm gonna introduce several people, but I'm gonna ask them to come up here and stand by me. I'm gonna ask Cody Hall, who is at the front lines of the Dakota Access Pipeline, the Red Warrior Camp. I'm gonna ask him to come up here and share some words. Then I'm going to ask my sister Kalama from Hawaii on the front lines of Mauna Kea protection and fighting and trying to keep what is sacred ours. I'm going to ask one of my sisters to come up. She's from the Apache stronghold protecting Oak Flat. My sister. These relatives have planted their feet on the ground and said, we're not going to move. And that's the example we want. That's the example we want our children to see. And after they are done, I also want, after these folks are done, I want Kathy Peltier to come up. She is the daughter of Leonard Peltier, one of our warriors who remains in prison, who is incarcerated unlawfully. He remains in prison. And we want him out, Obama. We want him out.
Yes, sir.
And so today, we're gathered because we stand in solidarity with all these actions. Not just one action. Not just the actions in Arizona, or the Dakotas, or in Hawaii, but the actions all over. And we stand in solidarity with our prisoners, our political prisoners, like Peltier. So I'm gonna ask Cody to kick us off and we're gonna go down the line. Thank you, relatives.
Thank you. Hope.
Dakapi. My Christian name is Cody Hall. My Lakota name is Tatanka Chikala, Little Buffalo. And I thank you guys so much for your support. We need to trend this big time of these actions that our indigenous people are taking on. You know, I'm gonna speak on the Dakota Access Pipeline because it's affecting us. People say, hey, you know, it's a native issue. It's more than just that. It's a humanity issue. We just happen to be on the front lines on this fight. You look at all the wars that we as Indian people, as indigenous people, as in my lands, the Lakota, we defeated the US government when we took down a 7th Cavalry. And that still leaves a sour taste in the government. So when we are taking this action to defend our land and our water, they get intimidated and they get scared. So now the governor of North Dakota is saying, we are gonna make a military presence. He's asking of that when he declared a state of emergency last week. What that is to demand federal funds so that in a script when he made a press conference, he put in there about how they're asking for law enforcement, but securities. So when I asked his office, what defines securities? What does that mean? Because I'm gonna tell you what it means from a Lakota's perspective. You're gonna ask for the military. Why are you asking for a military presence when it's peaceful protectors at this camp doing what we have always done is protect our people and our way of life? So me coming out here to help spread the word with the rest of my indigenous friends and relatives here, because we've been sharing everything on social media for months and months leading up to this. Mother Earth made a call years ago, and she asked for the protection because she knew that this was coming. And we heard that in ceremony. Now, when a grandmother is asking for help, that's in us to not turn that away. And that's in you guys. She made that call. You guys heard it down here. And you guys, with that vibe, with every vibe in your presence of your body, take note of that. Because she provides the first medicine on this earth, which is water. Water is sacred to us. Water is sacred to everybody. And so you guys, to be right here as I, if you want to speak to me afterwards later on, I mean, really, it's what is happening up there is monumental. It's a once in a lifetime thing going on. I'll never see this in my lifetime after this. 80 plus tribal nations gathered, and there's still more coming. And our non-native allies standing with us from around the world. We just, before I left, we had people from England show up that just said, you know what? Hey, I follow issues about Indian people, and I just want to take a stand because I need to be a part of this. We had brothers and sisters from South America show up that saw what was happening. Everybody from everywhere is taking part in this monumental thing. And we actually have the power to take down this conglomerate of energy, the energy companies and the oil companies. Nobody wanted to take that on. But we, as indigenous people, we as Lakota people said, we're gonna take it on and we're gonna make sure that this pipeline dies. And when that was told from our camp, people were kind of like, oh, hey, all right. The reality of it is really, you're up against a huge wall. But we've been that way our whole life. When they tried to exterminate us, no, they didn't do it, So here we are right now,
still
living,
here. Still
here.
Yes.
So I ask for your support. Whether you show up in person, we will welcome you. Just let the security know as you come into camp that you are here to stand with the Red Warrior camp people and their fight, and they'll direct you to our camp in the back. And whether you cannot make it, please keep us in your prayers and find us on the Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and MeWe pages that we have created to keep that narrative, because that narrative has to come from us, the truth. Look at CNN. CNN's not going to say it, but let's keep the pressure on them. Eventually, they will break because they don't have a backbone. So I ask of you guys in that way, in a good and healthy way, please keep us in your prayers, because as we go into ceremonies and sweat and all that back home, there's a lot of people that come here at that camp that are just heavy-hearted and just hurting because of what's happening to Mother Earth. So again, I thank you guys, and from our camp to you guys, we love you so much and thank you for your support. Doc Kathy.
Thank you.
Kalamaoka'aina Niheu, Paliku, Kapapa, Moko, Hina. My name is Kalamaoka'aina Niheu. I come from the island of Oahu, where we have the Paliku, the male aspect, with Kapapa, Moko, Hina. Together, united, they represent the strength of our people. And we stand here in solidarity of Standing Rock and Oak Flat because they try to tell us that these are in isolated incidents. And we know that over hundreds of years that the first peoples of the land are the ones who have always protected the land. And it doesn't mean that all nations can't rise up and protect the land, but what it does mean is that part of the oppression of the First Nations is intrinsically tied to the extraction and destruction of the planet as we know it. The world is hurtling forward in a headlong destruction of where the world will be going up in flames, destroying and melting the polar caps. And how are we going to live? How are we going to eat? How are we going to support our future? It's not just the First Nations, but we have to maopopo that we know. We have the science. We have the spirituality, we have the connection of how to take care of the land that is beneath our feet. So wherever you go, people ask us, how can you support Hawaii? How can you support Mauna Kea? And we say, you go to the first peoples of the land that you're at and support them, because it's very easy to support Mauna Kea over there. And it's very easy for you to support the African people here. But do you honor the First Nations of the land that you are walking on? Because that is where you look to where the First Nations are oppressed, that is where the destruction lies. So we're talking about the oil, we're talking about the transnational corporations, we're also talking in Hawaii, we are the most heavily militarized place on the planet. Our Hawaii is the center for PACCOM, and it is Mauna Kea and Haleakala are the center of the military process of which the United States controls half of the world's surface. We have places all over where people are standing in unity with all of the First Nations. And what we need to tell them is we will no longer wait for you. We have asked, we have told, we have educated, and no longer we will take our future with or without you. So ku kia imona, Standing Rock, Oak Flat, we are all united, we are one people, because revolutionary theory is useless unless it's applied. Mahalo.
Mahalo. Dagot e, yat e, she, kere, sage, kere, gonze. Good evening, everyone. I am blessed and humbled to be here standing in front of CNN, but I'm more blessed for all of you in this circle, like we gather, like our ancestors did. This is where the knowledge is spoken. All these elders here, I want to thank you, Ahia'e, for letting me get the mic and speak. I am from the St. Carlos Apache Reservation. I am there, and I don't know if any of you guys were at the event last night, but this is what I painted the banner.
Beautiful.
And, Right now we are fighting for our freedom of religion. And this is what I painted. This is the changing woman, the white painted woman. And this is Nejoni. This girl right here is named Nejoni. Beautiful. She's my little sister that stands with us. She's marched with us. She's walked with us. Her sunrise ceremony was held at Oak Flat, Chichirpetagote. And this is what we're fighting for, our sacred lands. Just like many of my brothers and sisters are, in solidarity, I stand with them. And when you have a fight like that, it doesn't come easy. My brothers and sisters, it doesn't come easy at all. There's a lot of sacrifices coming with this, with fighting. That's when you know you're doing the right thing. When you have sacrifices for your loved ones, when you're occupying, when you're away from loved ones,
reoccupying.
And they're praying, and many of you are praying with us. Ahia'e, for all of your prayers. Sean, I want to thank each and every one of you. And like I just said earlier on the mic, I am, as long as I live and I walk Nagostan, I'm gonna keep fighting for Chichil Pedagotil. They're not gonna take my sacred land. They're not gonna take my culture, my rich culture. I'm gonna keep fighting for the generation and the next generation. And I want each and every one of you to keep this fire going in the fight. Our blood, our veins, what is that blood? What did our ancestors fight for? For each of us to be right here, to have a voice, to not sit back and lay back and be blinded by TV and technology. Step away from that. Step out of that. Go to your sacred mountains. Go to your rivers. Pray to them. They need to hear your voice. They need these songs. They need to be danced on. Nikustan, what's the greatest thing that Creator gave us? Drum, first heartbeat. Dance. Dance on Mother Earth. She needs it. We're not harming anyone. This is a spiritual fight. We're fighting. We're teaching our young ones to prayer, the power of prayer. They don't understand that. These corporations don't understand that at all. Do they? They just want to keep taking and taking and taking from Nicholson. She's sick. She's sick right now. We keep taking from her. Our reservation, we were brought to our reservation, and they keep the little land that they put us on. They keep wanting more and more. They want our water. They want the copper. They keep wanting and wanting and wanting. When's enough going to be enough? And that's why each and every one of you are here standing with us. And as like I said, I come from St. Carlos, and there, people, there's a great woman warrior in my people. She was the sister of Chief Victorio Lozen. She had the power of medicine, power of prayer. I'm going to share a little story about her, because her spirit and her story, it touches me. She is of me. Her blood is in me. And I'm going to keep that spirit that she had, that fight that she had for her people. I'm going to keep that. What she had the power of doing is she would raise her hands with Geronimo and Victoria. She would raise her hands with these men. She would fight with the men on the front line. She would raise her hands, turn clockwise. And as she prayed, this to Yusin, she would pray for direction. And as her hands, her palms would get heated, that's where she knew the enemy was. And she would lead her people the opposite way. That is the power that Creator has blessed us, our ancestors. Don't ever forget that. To each and every one of you, know your chiefs, know your warriors. Matter of fact, stand as a warrior. Put those drugs, put the alcoholism down, and live in that light. Don't you see that light, that fire that's burning? See where it takes you. See where it takes you. See where it puts a voice, a seed inside your heart for your people. I'm gonna keep fighting for my community. I'm happy to be here in front of all of you. And when I go home, this weekend I'm gonna have a sunrise dance to go to. And then the following weekend after that, and the following after that. And I'm gonna keep my brother and his family in my prayer as I dance. I'm gonna keep my sister and her people in my prayer. I'm gonna dance hard for them. By that big bonfire, by the guns, Shemekoshe, I'm gonna dance hard, and I'm gonna keep each and every one of these fights within me and my heart. I'm gonna tell you guys really quick about a dream that I had. A dream that I had, I woke up, I was at home, and the drum beat was so loud. I'm running around in my room, and I could feel the whole earth on my feet. Boom, 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 boom. The whole earth was just one heartbeat. And I'm running around and I'm looking for my moccasins. My aunt was outside. I opened up the side of my door, and what do I see? I see a bunch of vibrant colors up in the sky. Just vibrant colors. Keep in mind that heart, that drum. I jump it back on my aunt's truck. All these vibrant colors in the sky, that drum beat. I start driving down the road. I'm in the back of my aunt's car, my Aunt Marge's car. And it's all indigenous people dancing, ceremonies, dancing. All these blessings that were going to Shaka, Father Sky, was healing Mother Earth, that one first heartbeat. In that moment, all I can do is chant. All I can do is just chant and be proud to be who I am. And man, indigenous. And I carry that with me, because before I had that dream, that's when we started having core meetings about Chichen. That's when we started having core meetings about what are we going to do. And that's very, very difficult, even in your own community, to wake up your own people. But don't ever give up. Don't ever give up, my brothers and sisters.
No.
It's day by day, it's sacrificing yourself. With that being said, I just want to say ahia e, ahia e, ahia e, ahia e.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask, you guys can go ahead and stand to the side. I'm going to ask that we have our sister, Kathy Peltier, to come up. And then I want Martin to come up.
And your daughter to sing.
So, and then my daughter is going to offer a song. And then we're going to turn that back over to the movement. And then we're going to raise these signs. We're going to stand here. And we're going to try to make some noise. But I want Kathy Peltier to say a few words. Kathy?
Thank you, Kathy.
My name is Kathy Peltier. I'm the last daughter of Leonard Peltier. Well, one of his kids. I don't know anything really about who my father is. I just know when I was 6 to 8 months old, I was handed to him in a car. So I don't know who my father really is. I just know he's my dad. We've been doing protests since we were little. We did the longest walk when I was 2 years old. Right now, what me and my brother are doing with Josie Trevor is having a demonstration on September 17th at downtown LA. Anyone's welcome to come. It's from 10 to 2. I'm very proud to know that all our nations come together for the Standing Rock. It gives me chills, and a good chills. And it's really good to see how many people come out and support. The only thing I can tell you is that my father is not really in good health condition still. He has diabetes. Right now he has an aneurysm, and they said they will not do anything until it becomes 5 inches. So, or 5 centimeters. I don't know the exact, but that's all I know about what's going on with him. He's really kind of closed off, I think, because of all of his health issues. And if you guys could just write him, just send him a postcard, let him know you're still in support of him. Just do it. He's at Coleman Prison. And yeah.
Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you, Kathy. Let's give it up for Kathy.
Woo! You have information?
So this young man I met recently, he came to one of the most sacred ceremonies that we hold. And his name is Martin. He's a young man. He's handsome. And he's funny, serious sometimes. But we know that sometimes our relatives in Hollywood, they get lost. And we have some Native folks out there who are in the business, as they call. And this brother here, Martin, he came out to our ceremony and he honored us with his presence. And he stayed for the time of the ceremony. And I was kind of surprised that he stayed. But then he gave me his family background, his history of who he is when he introduced himself to the leadership. And I told him, stay and pray with us. And he did. He's coming, there's a movie coming out, Magnificent Seven. And he's gonna be in that film. And I know sometimes when our Native brothers and sisters are in the Hollywood system, they get criticized. And I asked him, I said, you wanna say a few words? And he said, yes. And he's gonna whatever's on his heart is on his mind, but I want us to support him. He is sober, he is young, he's a warrior. He does ceremony, he knows his language. We need to support that, relatives, and we need to honor that. We need to recognize that, that people out here still, we're not Hollywood Indians. We're indigenous peoples who have many different talents. We have many different talents and we're amazing people. And he's one of them. And I'm asking Martin to come on up. Brother, come on up.
I just want to say a few words. It's good to be here. I'm really glad that you all are here. Unfortunately, it's under these circumstances. But I just want to say a few things about the water. We need clean water. Water is life. We got to stop this pipeline. You got to fight. Got to stand up. It's not so long ago that the President of the United States made a treaty with our people. And he said, as long as the grass grows, as long as the water flows, as long as the sun rises, your land will be safe. We got to hold them up to that. We can't let them forget. We've had a way of life that sustained us for thousands of years. So we don't need nobody telling us how to be. I'll stand in solidarity with the people of Standing Rock, the people who are out there on the front lines. All of you here, it makes me proud to see all these faces out here. And just remember that if we're gonna protect the land, we have to take care of ourselves, we have to take care of our bodies, we have to take care of the people around us. Eat clean food, keep positive energy, respect each other, be kind, share, be honest, and fight for what's right. Stand up for your people. Barashish.
Last night, my daughter surprised me coming into town. And she showed up at the event last night, and we raised over $2,000 for the Standing Rock camp. And we did really well. And my daughter is Dene, and I want to ask her to come up here and offer us a song, because that's what we do. We sing, we dance, we have ceremony. And I want to thank her for being here. She's got a flight in an hour, I think, and she's going back home, but I wanted her to just share her voice with you and recognize her as a young, beautiful, indigenous woman who stands strong, is a dancer, who loves her culture. And so I wanted to bring her up. I want Kahara come up and offer us a song.
I'm going to be offering a blessing song for you today to honor our ancestors. Tsodizin bahojon inuli kokone bete yamajene kone bete yamajene hena hena Tsodizin bahojon inuli kokone bete yamajene kone bete yamajene hena hena Hokage,
Tsodizin bahujan in a league or corner the day and a jinny. Corner the day and a jinny, he and a hay away. Hala a corn hook a day. Nahima sunny dawn a hitch a jinny flinny. Hashe one has shelter. Hojogona shadowless. Hojogone da dolet.
Thank you.
I'm gonna ask our brother to come back up one more time. Cody Hall, Chikla Patanka, Little Buffalo. I ask him to come this.
Asking you, let's give him a hand. Let's, for coming out here and wanting to support us and help us and to organize with us and all the things that they've been doing over this last week and this last weekend. So Cody?
Say, I just want to share something that a lot of, obviously, mainstream media won't pick up, but we did a Rhymes of Resistance concert on Sunday, and we do a concert every week. And as I was emceeing the event, I had a little girl in a jingle dress come up to me, and she tapped me on the leg, and she asked for the mic. And I, you know, just a little girl, and I thought, wow, okay, you know. So I bent down, and she said, I want to speak to the crowd. You know, I looked around like, hey, where's your folks or something? You know, her mom's standing there. She's like, she's very vocal. She's not scared of a crowd. And I'm like, sure thing, you know. We've had probably about 500 people standing out in the middle of a prairie there doing this concert. And she got up and she spoke something that was so powerful that came from a Tokoja, came from a little one. And she said, if oil gets in the water, then babies will die. And when she said that, it just sent a shockwave. And the people were just, you know, instantly started crying. That was a little girl that was telling the truth. And she got up and she just walked away like, you know, I'm done, you know? But yeah, it was so powerful. But also the other thing that I want to share is that we had four women that jumped the fence at this protest site because they were tired of seeing these earth movers raping Mother Earth. They couldn't take it anymore. And two of those women are like sisters of mine. And so as they were getting ready, they're amped up. They're like, Cody, we gotta do something. We have, you know, do something, Cody. And I was like, hey, I'm a media spokesperson. That looked pretty bad, you know, if I kind of did something like that. I don't know. I said, I'm trying to, I see what you're saying. And then all of a sudden, they just said, you know what? I'm tired of seeing what's happening with these earth movers. We're going to do something. And I didn't know what it was. So I was like, you know, my buddy Chase and I, he's a lawyer. And we said, hey, the legalities of this is that you might get charged with a federal felony. That's what they're putting out there. And one of my friends, she stopped. And just that, from her back, in her back of her head, she just kind of shook her head like, don't talk to me like that, buddy. You know, I'm gonna do what I want. She put her freedom on the line. And what happened was, is these four women stood in front of these earth movers. There was three of them out there. And they stopped construction. And from there, that company has never been back since. It took four women that inspired a camp. Four women. So the women truly are the backbone of who we are, of our existence. And I just want to share that with you guys, because every woman out here, you have everything in you to stop what is going on, the injustices, and we will back you up. And men, there are men out there on the front lines as well. But also, we do not get that unless we have that feeling and that love and compassion, that direction from our women and our children and our elders. So I am very thankful for what they did. And I just want to share that with you guys. We put it out on our page and we've told local media and they just kind of, whatever. I want to share that with you guys to let you know of these two inspirational things that happened at our camp. And again, I thank you guys and I love you guys so much.
Okay, I want to start a little small chant. Water is life!
Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life! Water is life!
All right, woo! Some sage going around, but there's this young man that asked to offer a song, and I told him, beautiful. I saw him singing earlier. In fact, he was probably one of the first people here. And the women, he's from Fort Yuma, and he wants to sing us a song. We're gonna let him do that, and the women are gonna support him. And we want to highlight the young people who sing these songs and do ceremony and live a good life, clean and sober. Love the people. Come on up, nephew.
My name is Tristan Salinas. I'm a poor man, poor woman, my poor woman, I'm a I'm a poor man, poor woman, my poor woman, I'm a I'm a poor man, poor woman, my poor woman, I'm a poor man, poor woman, my poor woman, I'm a poor man, poor woman,
He's from the American Indian Movement. He's right here. I want him to raise his hand. He took some food up there to the camp. Brothers, let's acknowledge him and thank him for doing that. Our brothers down in Morongo and Kumeyaay territory, Barona, they took a lot of food and we saw them online doing that. So there's a lot of good things happening, relatives. And so I think right now we're gonna turn it over to Larry and thank Larry and KPFK, the radio station here. Listen to it, support it. And our brothers, sisters, again, the American Indian Movement, thank you all for coming out. Thank you all for supporting these actions these last couple of days. There's a lot of things going on in Indian country. Don't sit there and watch TV. Don't watch CNN. Don't get brainwashed. Watch something else. Turn on something good. Listen to the radio. Larry's on it. The Kalamas was just on the station. So listen to what's happening in Indian country and get a 24 station. I don't know what that is, but so let's support Native people. Let's support our sisters and our brothers. There's Bethany Yellowtail. Where's she at? Raise your hand. She's one of our beautiful, beautiful designers. And so support them, relatives. Let's support these camps. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shannon.
Hello, thank you, Shannon. This comment, CNN's, if you ever watch CNN, a lot of their advertising is funded by the American Petroleum Institute. And yeah, Boo is right. And two members of the American Petroleum Institute is Marathon Oil Company and Enbridge Incorporated. And those two corporations just invested $2 billion into the Dakota Access Pipeline. So it is CNN who is complicit, and guilty for censoring the struggle to defend the traditional territories of the Hunkpapa, the Lakota, Nakota, and Dakota peoples. It is CNN who is guilty of censorship. It is CNN who is guilty of the propaganda of promoting the resource extractive industry. So keep that in mind if you watch CNN. Their advertisers are the oil companies. They are the natural gas companies. They are the resource extractive industries.
We're live here at the CNN building, who continues to ignore the real news that is going on, the real news that's important to all peoples, not just First Nations or Indigenous people, but all people of this earth. We stand here with many people from many nations, the First Nations, in solidarity for Standing Rock. We stand here for the water, against oil, against the big three corporations, in solidarity, hoping to open people's minds and hearts so that they pay attention to what is going on this earth to save our Mother Earth. We will not have anywhere to be if it is gone. So people, please stand up, Lokahi, come together, be in unity, and just open your eyes and ears and listen to what is happening around the world. We stand here in solidarity. Aloha.
Indigenous peoples have the right to access non-native media. We have the right to create our own media, but we also have the right to access the corporate media in the United States and tell our own stories with dignity, with respect, and with our voices. That is our right, and we will be heard, and we are being heard, as evident by our gathering here today. So with closing out, thank you, Hawo, for being here. Thank you to the Tongva people, to our elder, Gloria Arianas. It's always an honor and a blessing to be in the circle. I'm honored to be here with all of you. And I want to, just in closing out, turn over the mic to one of the organizers for last night and tonight, Lydia, and she'll acknowledge everybody else that's part of organizing this event. So, how about?
Thank you.
Thank you, Larry. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for coming here. This is the beginning. It's not the last. We're actually going to be here next Friday showing the Oglala incident here. We're figuring out the machinery with regards to a screen just to be able to be present on a four-day weekend for Labor Day. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't take the opportunity to talk about a couple of things that are happening locally. Like Standing Rock and definitely Apache Stronghold, the Oak Flat. It's a sacred territory, it's a sacred land, and a space that we hold, where we have ceremony, where we gather, where we come together and we connect, not only with each other, but we have that presence in our prayers with Creator. Our oceans, 1,100 miles of our coastal space, where the water, wherever the water is, 2 miles in, that's the coastal zone. There's something called the Coastal Act that's about to be gutted in the next November ballot. And they have a plan to just basically develop the land. And after this Coastal Act basically rules the coast, it makes it not accessible for the California tribes. And this particular law makes it available, the oceans and the beaches, open for you and the public. And I don't know about you, but I don't know any California tribe that's gonna try to apply for an application to hold ceremony before sunrise. It's just, it doesn't sound right. So when that comes up, I'm sure that we'll post things on the Facebook and Twitter and all that stuff. But also we have Banning Ranch. It's coming up September 7th at the California Coastal Commission in Newport. It's a Wednesday. Please go if you can.
Standing in solidarity with our First Nations brothers and sisters.